sharing the gospel with you today. Today is the 29th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Ordinary time is a time for us to grow in our knowledge and love for Jesus. When Jesus spoke of God's kingdom, many people listened to him and loved to hear what he had to say. But there were some people who were afraid of that Jesus had come to take away their power. They often challenged Jesus and hoped to make others think less of him. Jesus knew this, but he was obedient and faithful to what God his Father called him to do. Let's listen to today's gospel. Please stand and let us sing the Alleluia. Halle, halle, halle. Halle, halle, halle. Stars, your offering at the word of life. Halle, halle, halle. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. The Pharisees got together and planned how they could trick Jesus into saying something wrong. They sent some of their followers and some of Herod's followers to say to him, "Teacher, we know that you are honest. You teach the truth about what God wants people to do, and you treat everyone with the same respect, no matter who they are. Tell us what you think. Should we pay taxes to the emperor or not?" Jesus knew their evil thoughts and said, "Why are you trying to test me, you show-offs? Let me see one of the coins used for paying taxes." They brought him a silver coin, and he asked, "Whose picture and name are on it?" "The emperor's," they answered. Then Jesus told them, "Give to the emperor what belongs to him, and give to God what belongs to God." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Boys and girls, in today's gospel, we hear about two groups of people who tried to trick Jesus by asking him a difficult question. The question was designed to get Jesus into trouble with the ruler of the time. One group was called the Pharisees. The other group followed Herod Antipas, who was the ruler of Galilee and Perea at that time. The two groups were usually enemies, but this time they decided to work together to get Jesus in trouble. They wanted Jesus' opinion about paying taxes. Boys and girls, your parents pay taxes to the government every year, and back in Jesus' time, the people had to pay taxes too. Some people thought that by obeying the Roman rule and paying the tax, they would not be following God's law. Others thought that if Jesus said it was wrong to pay taxes, he would be suggesting that the people disobey the government. The people who wanted to trick Jesus thought there was no way Jesus could escape this question without making one of the groups very angry with him. But Jesus didn't take sides. Jesus knew if he listened to his Father, he would be able to answer the question honestly and truthfully. First, Jesus asked someone to show him a coin that was used to pay the tax. Then Jesus asked whose image was on the coin. They said, "The emperor's." So Jesus replied, "The coin has the image of the emperor on it. so then the money belongs to the emperor, and that we give to God what belongs to God. Boys and girls, what belongs to God? Why, of course, everything belongs to God, doesn't it? Yes, that's right. Everything we have is a gift from God. Look at your family and look at your friends. Every one of them have been made in the image and likeness of God. We are all created in the image and likeness of God. Isn't that amazing? And wow, look at the outside. Look at the beautiful world that God has given to us. Everything was created by God and belongs to Him. And since all of us and the world we live in belongs to God, we must be sure to treat one another and our beautiful world in ways that gives God honor, thanks, and praise for all that we have. Boys and girls, please take some time today to thank and praise God for all the wonderful people and the beautiful world He has created for us to enjoy. Okay? Okay. Let's bow our heads and say a prayer. God of all blessing, source of all life, giver of all grace in all things, I want to thank you for the gift of life, for the breath that sustains life, for the food of this earth that nurtures life, and for the love of family and friends. I thank you for the beauty of this great earth. Thank you for everything in my life and everything that has been created by you. For this, I am very grateful. Amen. Goodbye, boys and girls. Have a wonderful day. Enjoy the sunshine. And remember to love God with all your heart, mind, and soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. Bye-bye.